Hello, the time has come to discuss what is the fastest way to transfer lemonade from this side to that side. The way that is very slow is this way. Bubble by bubble by bubble by bubble. Why is that happening? The pressure here is always lower than the pressure there, because the pressure here is the same as the pressure there plus the hydrostatic pressure of this liquid. So that means that the air wants to go up. But when air goes through this very narrow opening, it actually closes off the liquid from going through the opening. So it's not until the air bubble has passed that liquid can flow again. And so you get a game, a play, liquid goes in, bubble comes up, then liquid goes in, it's an alternating process. I call that the bubble technique. It's very slow, it easily takes more than a minute, and there are even times that it can stop. It may not stop now, but if it stops, in general, it is when the differential pressure between here and here is low. I would like you to explain why that happened, so I leave you with a problem. I want you to discuss it among yourselves. I want to stay completely out of it, so don't send me your solutions. I may give you a hint, it may even be the wrong hint. You may not want to overlook surface tension. Okay, so this method is not a very good one. There are people who suggest, well, in order to keep the air always, the air tunnel, so to speak, always open from left to right, you just hold it near horizontal. And as you see now, you almost see no bubbles. But this is an even slower method than the bubble method. So this clearly is not going to help you. The moment you want to increase it, you get immediately bubbles. So that's certainly not a very, very useful suggestion. Some of you suggest if you poke a hole in here, then it may go faster. Well, it doesn't. You see, whether you poke a hole here or you poke a hole there, the liquid always has to go through that very narrow opening. You can't prevent that. And so if you poke a hole here, air still has to go up and it still has to go through the opening, and it will close off the opening. So that's not to work either. Others suggested, well, if you make one of those sides vacuum, or at least lower pressure, then that makes the differential pressure go up, and so that may then increase the speed of the liquid going, and so less time. What they overlook is that if you lower the pressure in any one of these sides, the atmospheric pressure from the outside will just crush it. I will show that to you. I have here empty bottle. Keep in mind that the outside pressure is equivalent to having a 1 kilogram weight on every square centimeter of this bottle. So the bottle is going to be crushed. I'm going to suck some air out and you will see the effect for yourself. You ready? I think I've convinced you. Okay. So that's not going to work either. So what now is the A plus solution? The A plus solution is that you create in the liquid a vortex, a tornado. So you spin the liquid. Remember, the solution to the egg problem was to spin it. Well, here you spin it also, but for a different reason. So the centrifugal force will move the liquid then to the side and creates a permanent opening in the middle, so that the air can flow without forming bubbles which close off the small opening. So are you ready for this? I will show it at least twice. So here is the bubble solution. Slow, tedious, but now watch. Vortex solution, tornado. You see it? Isn't that gorgeous? I'll do it once more. Bubble solution, very slow. Ready? Vortex is formed, and you can see here there's an air opening all the way through. There are no bubbles anymore. So this, in my book, is the A plus solution, okay? Many of you have this solution, at least 50%, but I never posted it because it wouldn't be fun for those who didn't find that solution. So if you were not posted, that means it's really a compliment that your solution was correct. Many of you know the idea of creating the vortex. I don't know when I will post another problem. It may take a few weeks. It's always difficult for me to find a problem. I can't put a math problem there. I'm not going to correct your math. In addition, almost any problem that I can think of, you can find the solution on the web. The Rattleback solution is on the web. The boiling and non-boiled egg solution is on the web. And this solution is also on the web, with videos included. In fact, a gentleman sent me on my site, on my YouTube channel, his video that he made in his home. And he made it because I posted this problem. It was very nice. It's a long video. It's about 20 minutes. And you can see him working on his computer and working on the transfer. He's very kind. His English is not perfect, but that's perfectly okay. It's very nice that he sent it to me. And you can try to find it on the web. So I will try to find another problem then, but almost certainly, if you put in some effort, you can find the solution on the web. So I may not do it as often anymore. Maybe at most once a month. Maybe not even that often. All right, have a nice day. Of course, we're still friends. And take care.